From a road that should never be driven on to a mental hospital turned community center, here is a bunch of places in China that you should never go. Number 5 on this list is the Forbidden City. The Forbidden City was constructed in the early 1400s for the Ming Dynasty. This palace served as the base of operations for any political ongoings that China was involved in for several hundred years. It was also the home to the Chinese emperors and their families. The complex is massive, consisting of 980 buildings, 8,886 rooms, and being 178 acres in area. The Forbidden City was listed as a World Heritage Site in 1987 and is no longer used for political business, but now acts as a tourist attraction. This palace is estimated to be worth over $70 billion, which makes it the most valuable palace and piece of real estate on the entire planet. I imagine that when they were valuing this palace though, they didn't factor in that it's deeply haunted. The Forbidden City has been home to many Chinese emperors during its existence. During its time, it's seen them partake in a wide array of atrocities. The murder of Chinese slaves has happened countless times. Granted, this hasn't always been done by an authoritative figure, but skirmishes between servants and slaves have happened many times throughout this palace's history. And also, it hasn't just been slaves, but others have been murdered within these walls too. Many people speculate on some of the sinister acts that have happened here, but many of those acts have never been proven. This leads to the secrecy that has shrouded this place since its construction. Nowadays, this Forbidden City is haunted by several ghosts and ghouls. One of the most famous sightings was from a guard. They swore that while they were on duty, they were approached by a lady in white without any face at all. This legend has been echoed by some of the other people over the years, although this lady's origin is unknown. Many people also report the sound of music coming from thin air as they walk through the palace. They also hear the laughter and crying from other women that can't be seen. It's believed that these are the ghosts of some of the concubines that used to live in this palace. The Forbidden City is one of the coolest palaces in the world, but we have to remember that it was forbidden for a reason. Number 4 on this list is Tuen Mun Road. This road is a highway in Hong Kong that links Tuen Mun and Suan Wan. The highway is only 19.4 kilometers long and for the most part is well kept. It was constructed in 1977 and during its short time of being active has developed quite the legend around it. This road is considered to be one of the most haunted roads on the entire planet, and that is largely due to the significant amount of death that it's seen. In 1978, it had its first fatal crash, and since then it has amassed massive numbers of accidents. In fact, this road has had hundreds of accidents, with many of them being fatal. Some people blame poor road design, but the surviving victims from the crashes, they blame ghosts. This road is believed to be haunted by a bunch of spirits. It's said that these accidents keep happening because the ghosts will appear in the middle of the road. Upon first glance, people will think that they're about to hit a person, swerve to get out of the way, and effectively cause an accident themselves. The biggest problem with this road is that it keeps getting more and more haunted. Like a virus, the people who die from spirits then become the spirits that are haunting the road. Nowadays, there are hundreds of spirits that haunt this road and can appear at any time, right in the middle of it, causing chaos and death. One of the most notable accidents that happened here was that of a bus in 2003, where 21 separate people died. This highway is a hazard to say the least, and one that I would avoid going down if I was ever visiting China. Number 3 on this list is Fengdu. Fengdu had to be included in this list because it's also literally called the Ghost City. It is a massive collection of shrines and temples that are dedicated to the afterlife located on the Ming Mountain. This place was built over 2,000 years ago and is deeply rooted in Chinese culture. The reason that it's called the Ghost City isn't just because people believe it to be haunted today, but because of a legend that took place many years ago. Two imperial officers named Ying Changshen and Wang Fengping went to the mountain to practice Taoism. Whilst they were at this place, the pair performed a ritual to become immortal. When you combine their two names into Ying Wang, you get the translation King of Hell. This goes along with the stories that these two immortal beings will drag people down to the underworld. This site and these two immortals are so critical in Chinese culture because it's believed that every single spirit will pass through this place when they die. That's right, guys. Fengdu is the location where a spirit will go immediately after their physical body ceases to function. There are three tests that the dead will go through before moving onto the next life. First, they must pass the bridge of helplessness. Then, they go through the ghost torturing pass. And then finally, they will wait at the front of Xianzi Palace. It's here that the ghost must stand on a stone for 3 whole minutes. If you are to be dragged down to the underworld, then it's at this time that it will take place. All of this ghostly activity has made this place very haunted. People have reported sinister laughs and strange noises coming from this place at all hours of the day. People have also reported hearing blood-curdling screams coming from nowhere. They think that these screams are coming from the torturing of those ghosts. If all of this is true, then there really is no point of visiting this place. If all of this is true, then there really is no point in visiting, because regardless of how you spin it, we're all gonna end up there one day anyways. Number 2 on this list is the Great Wall of China. The Great Wall of China is one of the 7 wonders of the world and truly a sight to behold. The total length of the Great Wall of China is roughly 21,196 kilometers. This wall was built over thousands of years, with the initial construction starting in the 7th century BC. Its purpose was largely to act as a defense mechanism between other nations and also to monitor what was coming in and out of their country. This wall is massive, more massive than anything we can really comprehend. In fact, to put it in perspective, I'm filming this in Toronto, Canada right now. Traveling to China from here is roughly 11,000 kilometers, meaning that the length of the Great Wall is long enough to go all the way to China and then come all the way back. Due to its massive size and means of construction, it's estimated that 1 to 2 million people died from just the construction of this wall alone. These 1 to 2 million people who died whilst making this wall are said to haunt it to this day. The ghosts of their souls still linger around various sections of the wall, with many sightings happening throughout the years. People have seen these ghosts laboring away or just standing at the top of the wall looking down upon them. They've also heard the noises of somebody working or the moans of someone in pain with no person in sight. 1 to 2 million people is a lot of people to have died from this ambitious project. That amount of untimely death has to leave something behind, and I wouldn't be surprised if this Great Wall truly was haunted. It's one of the 7 wonders of the world, so I won't tell you to never visit, but if you do, then just be wary. Number 1 on this list is the Xiaoying Pun Community Complex. This community complex, which is located in Hong Kong, was listed as one of the most haunted places in China for quite some time. It started off, as many haunted buildings do, as an old mental institute. This institute was built in 1892 and operated as a mental hospital until World War II. During World War II, this building was used as a hospital for any people fighting, but then in 1947 went back to its initial purpose of housing those who were clinically insane. It continued to function like this until 1971, when it was eventually closed down and the building was abandoned. As with many mental hospitals from that era, there were a lot of human rights violations that took place. Couple that with some of the death that it saw in its walls, plus its abandonment, and the legend of a potential haunting started to run rampant. In the recent years, this place has been converted into a community center, but even this immense renovation hasn't stopped the ghostly sightings. The most famous apparition is that of a man dressed in traditional Chinese clothing. It's said that his presence isn't uncommon, and he will often engage people in conversations if they're by themselves. It should also be noted that the mental hospital before it closed down was ravaged by 2 separate fires. Some people died during these blazes, and the spirits of those burn victims have reportedly been spotted in the past. People have said that they've seen them standing at the end of the hall, staring at them, completely burned and bloodied. With a history like this location has, it's no wonder that spirits are still sighted walking among it to this day. Well, there you have it, guys. That is our list of the top 5 haunted places in China you should never visit. Please comment down below if you've ever been to any of these locations before, or some other haunted spots in China that I didn't mention. Thank you so much for watching. I'll catch you next time.